Ladies and gentlemen, fight number 6.
Yes, what can you tell us?
Mate, the time bomb, what a massive record. He's got 43 fights, 29 wins, training out of the ACT. Big thanks to Australian Vitamins getting behind this one, taking on the local boy, Chris Nguyen. But the time bomb, he's fought all over the world. I think he just came back from China or Japan just recently as well. I think, fair to say, probably underrated, I think, after 43 fights, but just a true professional.
For the evening, out of the red corner, Chris Nguyen, a very good fighter. Bushy?
Yeah, Chris is an explosive fighter. And, you know, he's had 23 fights for 16 wins, former WNC Victorian champion, trained by Superboy and Dominic Leone out of Eight Blade Warriors. As I said, I wasn't being harsh on Josh before saying he's underrated. He's had 43 fights, but he just seems to go under the radar all the time. But he's fought some of the biggest scalps in the country, so this is a big step up for Chris.
Yep, and I mean, Josh recently fought Gon, which is eight of the best in Australia, and come up for a close points loss in Canberra. And like you said, he's been all around the world, so he's been over to China and Japan in recent, so... I think this will be a really good fight for Chris.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is bout number 6 on the card. We are live at Rebellion Muay Thai 18. This fight brought to you by AustralianVitamins.com. 5 by 3 minute rounds when the bell tolls. Your man in charge, Mr. Bryce Burwisel. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, trained by Gary Hamilton, out of the Stockade Training Center. With an official weight of 59.50 kilograms, a record 43 fights, 29 wins. 5 wins coming via knockout. Fighting out of Canberra, ACT, he is Josh Timebomb Turner. And across the ring, his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, trained by Superboy, out of Eight Blade Warriors, an official weight of 60.05 kilograms, a record of 23 fights, 16 wins, 7 losses, 1 win coming by knockout. Fighting out of Laverton, he's the former WNC Victorian champion. He is Chris Nguyen. Both partners, good round.
Absolute pleasure to be down every time.
Pleasure having you here, Andrew. Here we go for the, the 7th fight of the evening. I'm really excited about this. Every time I see Chris Nguyen, he always puts on a really, really good performance.
So unassuming as well.
So again, 5 3-minute rounds for every bout from now on's 5 minutes.
Both fighters know they've got a 5-round battle, so they're just taking their time, feeling out the distance. The time bomb's taking control of the centre of the cage, of the ring, I should say, but Chris isn't scared at all.
And the time bomb's got a nice cauliflower ear on the left-hand side.
Yeah, been keeping his hands up when those right hooks come over. Unless he's been doing a lot of clinching. We'll have some surprises in store for us tonight.
Now, I noticed that Time Bomb is looking almost at the navel of Chris Nguyen, whereas Chris has got his head higher up and is looking, I suppose, into the eyes or at the forehead of Time Bomb. Where do you stand on that, Andrew? Is that a personal thing? Is that being trained into them?
I think it's a personal thing. A lot of people look towards the chest and get peripheral vision for the rest of it. Some people choose to look down, but the odd look up, stare in the eyes, try and get him, psych him out a little bit. It's not too bad as well.
And interestingly, the Japanese don't look each other in the eyes because that's a sign of disrespect.
Oh, really?
When they're in the fight. Yeah, so they actually won't even look at each other. And they also believe that perhaps that you can steal somebody's energy by them looking to your eyes. Yeah, that's right.
Here's our cultural lesson for the youth.
Yeah,
that's it.
Stoked. Oh, big kick exchange from both the boys there.
Now you can really see the experience. 43 fights against 23. These guys are so calm. They're so predictable. They're so
calculated.
Thank you. And again, tongue is tied. I'll leave it to you boys for a minute. Give me a beer.
Yeah, the shots that they get thrown out from the more experienced guys are much more calculated. The timing's better. They don't throw as many unwasted shots. Not to say that the other guys aren't exciting. Man, what a card this morning.
Absolutely.
Roots, what a show.
Absolutely. And there you have it. So if you do want to try some amateur or watch some amateur fights, there is the Roots show that precedes the Rebellion show here at the St. Kilda Town Hall.
Or if you're up in Sydney next week, make sure you come to Sea Arm to Sydney. Beautiful.
Sorry, what's happening next week, Andrew? What was that?
Sea Arm to Sydney.
That's it. Up in Sydney. Great fight card for next week.
Should be an absolute cracker.
Would love to receive an invite to that, Andrew.
Ooh, yeah, play a card, bro.
So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
Round number one.
Just a very quiet first round from both boys. Not a lot happening, just sort of feeling, getting the range and just feeling the power, but obviously Andrew now will start stepping it up.
Yeah. I think Josh will be, well, they're just tipping Josh to be the first to put the pressure on, I think.
Well, Christian is no stranger to pressure, so I look forward to seeing that. There you have it. The time bomb just keeping Chris up against the ropes. Nice body shot.
That was a nice body shot. See the hands. He's got some real cheeky little hand combinations, Josh. And they've got to keep an eye. Chris has got to keep an eye for that as we push forward in the fight as well.
Nobody wants to get hit. Round two of this five-round battle. There you have it. Time Bob moving Chris up against the ropes.
Big shout out to Adam King, promoter of Tag Team Muay Thai up in Queensland. Got a big show on tomorrow happening as well. So big shout out to King, anyone knows watching.
I think he got a double header on tomorrow. So and he's got a couple of good fights lined up. Muay Thai everywhere. Great to see.
Yeah, it's happening all over the country. And of course, the tag team really sets him alight up in Queensland. And I know he's been working very closely with Master Sai Naji of recent times. So.
That nice right kick from Chris there, countering the hand combination. Left kick back, Josh, two left kicks.
Tom Bomb throws a great headshot there, which was caught by Nguyen. Didn't get him down onto the mat, though.
Nice left kick from Chris. Double up there from Josh.
Yeah, Josh really starting to step it up now.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful kick exchange.
That Chris threw two right kicks there, and if you couldn't hear it on the telecast, people, they absolutely slapped like a baseball hitting the side of a cow.
Josh is feigning that left kick. He's done a couple of high ones up to the forearms, and Chris has really got to keep his hands up later on in the fight. He kind of does a switch punch combination and fires up the left hand afterwards, so keep an eye out for that one. Nice right kick. Oh, big left hook there too.
Chris has been dropped a couple of times of recent fights, and I just think as the fight goes on, you seem to drop his hands a little bit and he gets tagged.
Yeah.
I think he's had a couple of KO losses of recent times. Okay. So, against someone like Josh, you've got to keep it stuck to your head.
Keep your wits about yourself.
And it's interesting you mentioned it, Bushy, because Chris does tend to drop his right hand a little bit as the fight goes on.
Yep. There we go. Josh working the body. Chris counters with some high kicks to the arms.
And the right bicep and shoulder of Chris Nguyen's already looking really, really red.
Nice right kick.
Some nice power being shown by the time bomb.
Yeah, Josh is really starting to look comfortable, switching up his stance.
Oh, nice left knee too.
That left knee really hit the elbow and hurt the side of Chris Nguyen. That's going to hurt. Into a nice tight clinch, very traditional. Beautiful double right knee there from Nguyen.
That left kick again. The left kick's working a treat for him tonight. There it is again,
yep. Right, straight left. Oh, swing and a miss.
He really lifted it up, and he looks so comfortable when he switches up into southpaw.
He's really working the levels too. You can see him peppering away up the top, punching down low, coming back up high with the kicks. Here we go. But again, the power is going towards Chris. So when Chris comes back, he just lands that big single shot. See, here we go.
Nice low kick there from Nguyen.
There it is. One comes back. There we go again. Yeah, I don't think Chris wants to stand there and trade hands with Josh. He's quick, punches are crisp, he's been around the block. He can fight both Southpaw and Orthodox, and yeah, it's just not a good place to be for Chris in this fight, I think.
There, you've heard it from Andy.
It was interesting. We saw that kick earlier on, which caught the time bomb right on the knee and sort of buckled his knee out a bit.
Here we go into the third of five rounds. Oh, nice left-right combo there from Time Bomb. I think we're getting into the action end of the evening.
Here we go.
Yeah, Chris, beautiful headshots there from Nguyen.
Chris has really been told to step it up by Superboy.
Both fighters really showing a lot of power, a lot of technique, and a lot of fists at the opening here of the third round.
Oh, big right hand. Kick, right hand count from Chris. Big step up there. Nice left kick there from Josh.
Beautiful straight right there from Nguyen. Snaps the Time Bomb's head right back.
Hooked the leg kick.
It's one thing, previously Chris has always used his legs and chopped away at people really well. He's not doing it as much tonight with Josh.
And although Josh, oh, great timing there from Chris. Although Josh has got a lot of power in his fists, Nguyen's shown that he can throw power as well. He's actually knocked Josh a couple times and has worried him a little bit with those headshots.
Yep. Being the less experienced guy too, Chris really wants to let him know he's there for the fight too. Oh, big right knee, turn a right knee, another one. Josh coming back with some counters. Josh not scared of the clinch in here, he's really trading with Chris.
Some beautiful knees to the body from both fighters.
Oh, losing positions, Josh. Nice left elbow. Sneaky one just on outside of the clinch there, teeping away.
I'll tell you what, it's like the fight's only just started in this round.
Oh, getting a nice turn there from Chris. Getting into a dominant position here in the clinch. Josh needs to be a little bit careful. He doesn't stay in there for too long, I think. He's done a great job so far, but I think if he stays in there for too long, he might struggle. Left kick.
So I reckon Josh has done his homework on Chris, knowing that he has a tendency to drop his right hand a bit. That's probably why he's switching up into southpaw a bit.
Nice left knee from Josh.
Beautiful right kick, leg kick there from Chris.
Here we go. Got to follow up with kicks too.
Much better third round for Chris, and he knows it. Walks back to his corner with his hand up.
What a fantastic third round. I'll tell you what, these two very experienced fighters know exactly where and when to put on the pressure. We go to the replay. There's a beautiful body shot there from Chris.
That left kick works a treat. Caught the right hand for his troubles. There it is.
Yeah, catches it. Decides not to go for the takedown. Chris does not flinch.
That was a really nice
shot. That was so well timed. That was just such a show of technique and timing. Those good trade of knees in that clinch.
Josh has done the right thing, and you can see he's gripping his hands together. Even though he's on the outside, he's still able to stay upright. The moment those hands come apart, being on the outside, you're going to see him in a bit of trouble, I think.
Round four, and I'll tell you what, if the boys step it up even a little bit more, we're in for a treat.
here you have it. These are known as the championship rounds.
Big shout out once again to AustralianVitamins.com getting behind this one.
Into the clinch, training knee for knee.
Nice left elbow, left knee to finish up. There it is, left knee on the way in. Yeah. You can see he's got that real deep lock around the back there. Both hands, I think the MMA commentators call it the double plump.
The double plump. A few fighters copped it in the double plump earlier in the evening. Great knees to the body for both fighters here.
Josh needs to get out of here, I think, guys.
And Chris certainly is winning the superior shots to the midsection. You're right there, Andrew. Great. And like you said, Bushy, Chris is really starting to find his rhythm.
There you go. Head down. See? Here we go. Clinch is starting to take it out of him a little bit. Josh really needs to stay on the outside and get out of there. Nice work from Chris, breaking him down slowly, yanking on the neck, putting all his weight behind it. Even though there's not as many knees from Chris coming through, they're big and strong. Like, and that was massive.
And he's putting so much pressure on the neck and the shoulders and the head of Josh. He's got to carry all that body weight.
Yep.
And nobody wants to carry extra body weight. I can tell you.
Stick on the outside, keep working that left kick, work on the angles. That's Josh. Nice left kick.
And interestingly, Josh is predominantly fighting out of southpaw now as he switches back to orthodox, yeah. Just as you say.
Teasing you, he's teasing
that. Always happens. It always happens.
Josh trying to smother him there. Just grabbing on the ropes a little bit.
The left flank of Josh is very red. A testament to the strikes that Chris is landing.
Double up on the left, big right, the comeback double up from Chris too.
Wow. That's it.
There we go.
Send and return left, right from Chris Nguyen. The crowd's absolutely wild here at Rebellion Muay Thai 18.
Nice right, kicked him off the center there.
Josh is breathing
heavily. Big right kick up the back.
Look at the timing of Chris.
Yeah, this is a really good performance from Chris Nguyen. He stepped up against Josh Tonner with double the amount of fights, and he's really taking it to the time bomb at the moment.
Really is.
Oh, beautiful spinning kick there from Josh. One round.
Round four.
Yeah, and I tell you what, the last two rounds Chris has grabbed.
Yep, that last round, mate, that was a real, real good win, a round for Chris in that one.
Absolutely. Let's go to the replay. Here you have it. They're in the clinch, and they're, like you said, those knees from Chris in the clinch, Andrew, are just absolutely razor sharp.
Like, the knees are there from Josh, and he's really kind of holding his own in that respect, like numbers-wise, but yep. When you see the ones that are coming back from Chris, they're just that much stronger, and that deep lock there that you can see with both hands around the back there is really starting to take its toll. On the next round, Josh's got to stay on the outside, in my opinion.
Absolutely. I mean, you're right, they are going one for one, but as you said, Chris is making the damaging shots. And in a five-round battle, you can't afford to take too much of that damage. There you see Chris receiving instruction. Of course, Chris Nguyen fighting out of Eight Blades Warriors here in Victoria, up against Josh the Time Bomb Tonner coming out of the ACT. Seconds out.
All right, both fighters touch gloves. Melbourne, let's make some noise. This is the fifth and final round.
Here we go.
Here we have it. Do not blink, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching a sold-out show here at the St. Kilda Town Hall Rebellion Muay Thai 18. Josh the Time Bomb Tonner, Chris Nguyen.
Chris is really starting to step it up, spinning back elbow there from Josh, but just caught on the forearms from Chris. Chris's confidence has really built through these last couple of rounds.
Chris tries to step in and get into a clinch, but Josh isn't having any of it.
Oh, nice right kick. The redness starting to show there too. You can see some welts.
Oh, and Josh is trying to run away from Chris.
Big hands from Chris Nguyen as well.
I'm really loving the activity and the level of speed that both fighters are showing at this fifth and final round.
Isn't that great watching the little guys? The speed is fantastic.
And it seems so fresh so far into the fight. It's amazing.
Here we go. Still, he's got that. Oh, both hands around the back.
That's it.
Turn him around. Big takedown.
Very good display of technique there from Josh Tonner. Yeah.
Josh just attempting a bit of a cartwheel kick at Coppin, a kick up the floor for his troubles. A big right kick there from Chris, looking for the big strong finish. Welds, Chris, blocking, evading.
Yeah, Chris is just looking so composed with Josh. Yeah, with double the amount of fights in front of him. He looks relaxed, he looks comfortable in there.
Really does.
Chris will be so
left
confident.
Kick. Oh, big right hand counter.
Chris has dropped his right hand up. He's got to keep that right hand up.
Josh trying to put on a show here and getting countered, unfortunately, all over the place. Spinning heel kicks, copping a kick to the back, jumping kicks, getting caught and countered. What a fight.
What a fight.
What a fight, Melbourne. With time on Josh Tonner. Chris Nguyen, brought to you by StrandBottom.com.
Here you go to the replay. Beautiful sweep there from Chris Nguyen. So well timed. His timing really was superlative this evening.
It really was. Whether or not how the judges scored the fight earlier on in this bout is really going to tell the tale, I think, because Chris was really comfortable, especially in the fourth and fifth rounds. But how they judge that round one, two, and three, I think that's just going to decide on who wins this bout.
So Bushy hasn't got the rival night. What's it going to be, Bushy?
Mate, I reckon from the third round onwards, I reckon Chris did enough.
Yeah.
So I'd give the last three to Chris. Josh, certainly in the first round, just controlled it. Second round, fairly even. I think 3, 4, and 5 was, for me, was all Chris, but I've been wrong in the past.
We've gone to the judges' scorecards. Your three judges scored the contest 49-47, 48-47, and 49-47, declaring a winner via unanimous points decision. Red corner, Chris Nguyen.
Well, there you go, guys. Unanimous points decision win to Chris Nguyen. Probably the biggest scalp of his career.